Dear children, this is Sunita Mishra. Today again I am going to continue with the cell chapter. So the next thing is cell structure of cell. All cells have the following three major functional reasons: the cell membrane or plasma membrane, the second is nucleus, and the third is the cytoplasm. Now first we will discuss about the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is a living, thin, delicate, elastic and selectively permeable membrane. Now why we called it as a selective permeable membrane? Because it allows only the selective materials to pass through the cell. Now various model has been suggested regarding plasma membrane, but the model suggested by Singer and Nicholson in 1972 was a very well-known model for plasma membrane. This model is known as fluid mosaic model. It says that plasma membrane is made up of a bilayer, that means two molecule thick layer of phospholipid. Two types of protein molecule floated about in the fluid, that is phospholipid layer. Now when we discuss about the functions of the plasma membrane, then what is the main function? That it permits the entry and exit of some materials in the cell. Therefore it is called the selective permeable membrane, as I already told you. Now it performs certain physical activities like diffusion, osmosis, and certain biological activities like active transport, endocytosis, etc. Now first we will discuss about what is a diffusion. It is a very common process. We will see it in everyday's life. Now when there is a spontaneous movement of the molecules from a region of the higher concentration to a region of the lower concentration, until the concentration of both the medium will be same, then that process is known as the diffusion. Then comes to the another next process, which is which also occurs in plasma membrane, and that is known as the osmosis. Osmosis is very much similar to the diffusion. The only difference is that here there is a need of the semi-permeable membrane. So we can define the osmosis in such a way that the passage of the molecule from a region of higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. So when we are talking about the solutions, the molecules, then we have to also discuss about the three types of solutions that concentration will be happen in plasma membrane. So the three types of solutions will be the hypotonic, isotonic and hypertonic solution. Now first I will tell you what is a hypotonic solution. Now if the medium surrounding the cell has a higher water concentration than the cell, then that solution is known as a hypotonic solution. In this case, the cell will gain the water by osmosis. Okay, then isotonic. Isotonic means that concentration of both the solutions, either it is inside the cell or outside the cell, that is same, then that is known as a isotonic solution. Then what is an hypertonic solution? Now if the medium has a lower concentration of water than the cell, then the cell will lose water by osmosis. Then such a solution is known as a hypertonic solution. So we will all discuss about the three types of solutions that processes has always takes place in plasma membrane. Now the plasma membrane, in plasma membrane there is always a transport of the molecules takes place. So we will say that transport as a mediated transport. So plasma membrane acts as an effective barrier to the free diffusion of the molecules of biological significance. So on basis of that we can classify the mediated transport into two types: active transport and passive transport. Now first I am going to tell you what is an active transport. Now, if the movement of the material through the plasma membrane will be against the concentration gradient, that means it will opposite to the direction of the concentration gradient, then that is known as the active transport. Then what is passive transport? It can move the materials across a biomembrane down the concentration gradient. Okay, so these are the two types of transport that regularly takes place in plasma membrane. Then when we are talking about all the processes that takes place in plasma membrane, there are two topics left there, and that one is endocytosis and phagocytosis. Now, what is endocytosis? Endo means inside. So that means when ingestion of the materials by the cell through the plasma membrane, then that is known as a endocytosis. Now, it is a collective term that describes three similar processes. That is a phagocytosis. Phagocytosis means cell eating. Protocytosis, that means cell drinking, and receptor mediated endocytosis. Okay, now phagocytosis generally occurs in the protozoans like amoeba and lower metazoans like sponges. Now, what is an exocytosis? That is the membrane of a vesicle fuse with the plasma membrane and extrude its contents to the surrounding medium. This process is called the exocytosis. So we will discuss all the related activities which occurs through the plasma membrane. Okay, so these are the activities which takes place in the plasma membrane, and by that the plasma membrane will select the selective molecules, particles inside the cell. So today, up to this, we will meet in the next class. Up to then, bye and take care of yourself.